Welcome back to Eurovision Feels. It's your girl, Leet, and today we're going to be talking all about Austria. Let's discuss. Austria are a country to me that they're okay at Eurovision. There's been times when I've been like, whoa, those songs were like really highly scored by the juries and I don't get it. But I will always remember 2014 and how I was on the edge of my seat waiting to see if Conchita or the Common Linnets would win. And I wanted the Netherlands to win that time. But you cannot deny the power of Rise Like a Phoenix. Ooh, that song is just everything. Conchita did amazing, honestly, so well, and what a star she is. And yeah, I think Austria will continue to get good, solid results at Eurovision if they keep up the good work, you know. And we have Vincent Bueno with his song Amen. He was a participant from last year, however the contest was cancelled, so he didn't get a chance to sing his song alive, which wasn't too bad. It wasn't a favourite, it wasn't the bottom, it was just like a nice solid track, very kind of Bruno Mars, Justin Timberlake vibes, you know, gave me those feels. But yeah, I'm excited for this one. Hopefully it's a good track.
Amen.
Okay.
I guess. You said that it's time for us to put our love
To rest. Yep.
Dressed in black, you left my neighborhood.
Oh wow, and this is deep.
I thought you'd bury me and you. No, I never thought we'd die.
Oh, this relationship is donezo. Okay.
But amen.
Ooh.
Amen.
Okay. He has a nice voice. Nice voice, yeah. Video's cute.
Marching back, a plane gone too soon. No, I never thought you'd bury me in you. No, I never thought
you'd
die. Amen. Amen. Tell me.
This is very standard top 40, top 100 pop song. You didn't try, bud. You just didn't try. Break.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Tell me, is this what you wanted?
Is this really what you wanted? This is nice. Nice. A bit forgettable, to be honest. It was really sweet, and he is a little pop star, I can see it. But this song was a little 2006, 2007, 2008. Like, I've heard this song a million times over by a million different artists. In the Battle of the Amens, not that I want to compare, but Slovenia kills it for me in comparison. This just doesn't do it for me. And like, I just, what is he really going to bring to the stage, really? There's not much more I can expect from him unless like a choir comes out or something. There were elements to it that I liked. The beginning was cool because that will grab your attention. I think that was a cappella, right? So that was really nice. And I was focused. I was like, okay, he's talking about the death of a relationship. Then it kind of went into the chorus, which is like, whatever. But then it was climactic at the end and it was like, boom, yeah, going for it. And I liked that. But this song will not win. I don't know if it will even qualify, to be honest. We'll have to see. I'm going to give the song 2.5 stars. Just because it's a little samey and I've heard it a lot, but it is a nice song. It's something that I'm not offended by. It's not something where I'd be like, oh my God, I cannot listen to this ever again. In terms of, you know, originality, uniqueness, new flavour, no. And there's nothing wrong with ballads. Some of my most favourite Eurovision songs have been ballads, but they need to be done in a way that just, it's like all the magic ingredients. It just all comes together in this perfect recipe. And this for me was just missing something. Anyway, that's what I think. Let me know what you think. Comment below, subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye.